السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We present to you lesson number 904 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Our topic today is the Battle of Badr. Today is the 17th of Ramadan 1439. Let us see what is the background of the Battle of Badr, Ghazwa-e Badr al-Kubra, as it is known. Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in Medina Munawwara with the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in. Abu Sufyan was returning from Syria and they would pass Medina Munawwara to come back to Makkah Mukarrama. So this is known as the Eir, so the caravan, and it was laden with full of stuff for the people in Makkah who will go and sell their things and merchandise. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam's desire was to intercept this, because they, the mushrikeen and polytheists, had confiscated and usurped everything that belonged to the Muslims in Makkah Mukarrama. So this was an easy target, and Abu Sufyan and a few men, not so many with them. But Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala states, لِيُحِقُّ اللَّهُ الْحَقَّ وَيُبْتِلُ الْبَاطِلُ. Almighty Allah wants the haqq and the truth to be triumphant and destroy and annihilate the batil and finish them up. وَلَوْ كَرِيَ الْمُجْرِمُونَ. Although the enemies and the criminals detest it. There Abu Jahl, he heard about all this, and Abu Sufyan sent a message that no, go back, there is no need. But Abu Jahl and his pride and arrogance, this is mentioned in the Quran Sharif, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ بَطَرًا وَرِعَاءَ النَّاسِ. Do not be like those people who left their homes, here referring to Makkah, with pride and arrogance, and to show off to the people, وَيَسُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ, preventing people from the path of Almighty Allah. Nevertheless, thereafter the Muslims came, and the advantage was already with the mushrikeen and the polytheists. They were in that land that was consolidated, and they were nearer to the water wells. And remember, they were numbers 1,000 approximately, Muslims 313, ill-equipped. And remember that night, so the battle of Badr Friday and 17th of Ramadan, second year after Hijrah, that Thursday night, Laylatul Jumu'ah, Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam crying, begging, beseeching Almighty Allah, Allahumma intuhulik hadhil isaba lan tu'bad ba'dal yawm. Oh Allah, if this group of people are martyred, your name will never be taken, Ya Allah. The shawl mubarak of the Master alayhi salam fell, and said, O Bakr radiallahu anhu, thaniyas name, the second of the two. He was there everywhere. Wadna Master alayhi salam, hasbuka hasbuk, stop, stop, Ya Rasulullah. Victory is ours. Miqdad radiallahu ta'ala anhu was fired up, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, we will never tell you like what the Israelites told Musa alayhi salam, idhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila inna hauna qaidun. You and your Allah go and fight, we are sitting here spectators, Allah forbid. We are those people, Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, salma shi'ita, silman shi'ita, waqta man shi'ita. Ask whatever you want, we will dice with death till the end. You join us with whoever you want to, you cut us off with whoever we want to. These are the Badri Sahaba, the greatest companions of Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That Friday morning, Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mobilizing, organizing his troops and the army. And remember the other side, Abu Jahl and his cronies, they are also, they were overconfident of victory. They brought the women who were singing on way, and the victory songs were already playing, and the alcohol, the wine and the swine was all being used by these enemies of Islam. So remember, the battle erupts that Friday, 17th of Ramadan, second year of the Hijrah. Lo and behold, we find line, the enemy had lost 70 men, including Abu Jahl, dispatched straight to Jahannam and the Hellfire. And the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala an, we see that they are the ones that the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala an whom, they are the people who lost 14 Sahaba, became Shaheed. Their Mubarak graves are still there. And Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that these bodies of these enemies, throw them in the wells and so forth. Their Qalib Badr, as they are known. So this was, and 70 of them were taken captive. So this was like the backbone of the kuffar, the mushrikeen, being broken, and they could not understand. Imani quwwat. What is the power of iman? What is the power of Quran and Sunnah and obedience to the Master sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Therefore, O Ummah, this day, 17th of Ramadan, in the Quran Sharif is called Yawm al-Furqan, the day of criterion, the day Almighty Allah let the haqq prevail and let the batil and the falsehood perish. So today we are facing many, many challenges from the Zionists, from the Shia, and from many others. So always stick to the truth with the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, and inshallah we will stand with Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu anhu, Sayyidina Usman radiallahu anhu, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, Amir Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, Sayyida Aisha, Sayyida Hafsa radiallahu anhu, and all the other spouses of the Master alayhi salam. That is our duty. So always see what was sacrifices the Sahaba radiallahu anhu made for Deenul Islam. Barakallahu fiqh. Salamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.